How can signatures be made up? This controversy we debated yesterday on the news. I had different points of view. Yesterday on the news, we were debating the ethics of writing to Barack Obama, the ethics of beseeching slash begging Barack Obama not to give Modi a visa. But today we are on another subject, that how can these letters be fake slash forged? 9 MPs write, say we did not sign this. Then was this a cut and paste job? Implications are serious. Let me say this right on top of NewsHour tonight. The implications are extremely serious if the letters were forged. On the debate tonight, Shantaram Naik of the Congress Party, he has signed. He's part of the 65 MPs. He does not deny signing. Shantaram Naik, you don't deny signing, I think. And your sign is number 17 on this list. And also with us is Ananda Bhaskar Rapulu from Hyderabad. Mr. Rapulu, can you hear me? Arnab here. Mr. Rapulu says he has not signed, though his name and signature is mentioned in number 20. Now, this is very interesting. We also have G.N. Ratan Puri, who's a member of Parliament of the National Conference. He says, I have signed. I'm not denying I have not signed. And his sign is at number 7. His signature is there. He's not denying it. So we have 2 MPs who admit signing, 1 MP who says, I never signed. Therefore, his signature is forged. Suresh Prabhu is very angry about this. Former cabinet minister from the Shiv Sena in the NDA government, former environment minister of India, Suresh Prabhu, welcome. Thank you for joining us. You know, Piyush Goyal, national treasurer, member of parliament of the BJP in the Rajya Sabha. Syed Aziz Pasha is with us. Mr. Pasha, good evening. Mr. Pasha, you yourself, now let me start with you, because you're in the most interesting situation. For our viewers, Mr. Pasha is a member of the National Executive of the CPI. And he says he has seen Sitaram Yechury sign the letter. I spoke to Sitaram Yechury earlier today, and Mr. Pasha, he says he's not signed any such letter. So who's lying? You are lying or Sitaram Yechury is lying? Let's start with you.
Oh, I never said that Mr.
Yeah?
I never said that Sitaram Yechury signed in my presence.
Okay.
See, he might have signed. Somebody told me that Sitaram Yechury has also signed. That was the news given to me. But I was not there at the time.
Mr. Pasha, you have been quoted as saying, I remember vaguely Sitaram Yechury also signed it. But today when he is refuting, I have to think whether my memory is correct. How does your memory change in 12 hours?
No, I didn't say that he signed in my presence. I only said that the persons who took my signature, they told me that Mr. Sitaram Yechury has also signed it. I don't know how far that is correct.
Now we have 2 MPs of the Congress Party. 1 MP of the Rajya Sabha, Ananda Bhaskar Rapulu, right? And we have another MP of the Rajya Sabha, Shantaram Naik. First, Mr. Rapulu, you did not sign the letter. Have you signed the letter, Mr. Rapulu?
There is no necessity for us of Indian National Congress to send such type of communication to foreign country head. And first of all, we are not at all to make out such appeals to anybody else, and it is not going to have any
great thing
that if he is to get any visa.
No, I'm going to hold this up. I don't know if there's a television set near you. I'm going to hold up your signature. If the camera comes closer, viewers, this is the biggest political mystery tonight in the country. A letter has been written against Narendra Modi to say don't give him a visa, and the letter has gone to Obama. Where my pen is number 20, you would see the name of Ananda Bhaskar Rapulu with the signature. Mr. Rapulu, is this your signature? Let's go close, please. Mr. Rapulu, is this your signature?
Yeah, that shall be mine. How come that paper has reached and affixed to the letter that has been addressed to
Obama? No, my God. Then you are talking of forgery. No, this is your letter. So somebody forged your letter? Your signature?
That is how I sign, but I never interacted with Adeep ji about this. He has never talked to me about his intention
This is Mr. Apollo, 1 minute. Let me explain to viewers what is happening. In case you did not watch the News Hour yesterday, last evening, ladies and gentlemen, on the News Hour, I debated the ethics of whether 65 Indian MPs should write to Obama and not to their own government on the issue of Modi not getting a visa. Today, I find 9 of these MPs are saying this is not our letter. In other words, there were forged letters sent to the US president on letterheads. Look at the letterhead. It's MP letterhead. Mr. Piyush Goyal, you recognize it?
Yes, I have it.
This is you have a letterhead like this as well?
Absolutely.
And the letter, Mr. Rapolu, let me inform you, the letter says don't give Modi a visa. So it's a forgery. Have we caught a forgery on television tonight in your view?
National Congress, Arnab ji. Mr. Arnab.
Yes.
There is no necessity for Indian National Congress or its members or even members of parliament belonging to Indian National Congress to address to US President about a visa to an individual. What is the great thing that an individual going US and doing there is not going to have a mandate from US?
But that's not, that's another issue.
The issue today is that
there are 9 forged signatures by members of parliament. 9 signatures of MPs have been forged. Isn't this serious? Let's get Piyush Goyal into the debate. What is the implication of this?
I think
forgery is a crime.
I think, Arnab, of course, forgery is a very, very serious crime in India. But there's a very much deeper issue involved. These are signatures of members of parliament. They are the custodians of India's integrity, security, or national policy. Tomorrow, such forgeries, if they are allowed to happen, and at the end, there are, after all, 65 MPs.
Yes.
Some of them claim to have actually signed it.
Yes.
So that means they are aware of the forgery.
Yes.
Of the others.
Yes.
So this seems to be a very, very deep-rooted conspiracy against the very integrity and security of India. And I'm sure everybody is aware, all these MPs are aware.
Are you alleging conspiracy?
I'm alleging conspiracy because there are some who claim they have signed. And then in between, there are others who claim they have not signed.
There are 2 people who
say
they have signed.
So people are aware of the forgery. Yeah. Others are aware of the forgery.
Well, you are putting... Well, that's serious. Now, Mr. Shantaram Naik, Mr. Ratan Puri.
Yeah.
Piyush Goyal of the BJP is claiming that 9 MPs have been fooled or their signatures have been forged. And he's saying maybe some of the others are aware of this forgery. Were you aware of this forgery? Or any such forgery?
I'm not aware of this. See... I can't say whether it is forgery. I can only say that I have signed this letter. I have signed my name, first written in capital letters, and then a signature I have put. I recognize both my name, which is written in capital letter, and also signature. And therefore, I am saying that I have signed this duly.
No, there are serious questions over the authenticity of the letter now, Mr. Ratan Puri. There are questions over the authenticity of the letter. 9 MPs, including Sitaram Yechury, have claimed they did not sign the letter. In fact, Yechury alleged it is a cut and paste jobs.
Oh, jeez.
He says it's a cut and paste jobs. There are claims by 9 MPs they did not sign the letter. Mr. Ratan Puri, did you try and establish the authenticity of the document at the time you signed the letter? At the time it was being sent to the White House?
I read the whole... Yes. I read the document fully. And I have gone through the document again. I have a copy of the letter with me. It has been sent to me by Mr. Adeep today. And I remember every word of it. I have signed it. I have written my name in capital letters. And I don't find anything beseeching or begging in it. There are we have said, we urge upon you sincerely at one place, respectfully at other place, and at third place we have said we want to express our concern. I don't know as much English as everybody else must be knowing on the panel, but
no,
I don't think
said
it is
don't
beseeching
give Modi a visa.
Or begging. We urge upon you. Yes.
Arnab, just yes, want yes, to yes. raise an issue of
now
propriety.
Now listen to me, please. Hear me. Okay. Yes. Hear me. Please hear me. You have not used words alleged. When you say, Mr. Arnab Goswami, when you say, oh God, this is forgery, please say this is alleged forgery. Somebody alleged this is forgery. It has to be established whether it is forgery or not. You can't see. And
they
now
are not written in this
We are asking tonight, one second. I have no reason to disbelieve Sitaram Yechury and the other MPs. I have no reason to disbelieve you. And whereas, all I am saying is,
whereas they have not written, it is alleged that Modi presided over. They have made all allegations without any courtesy. They have in fact bypassed the judicial process in India. They choose to stand as judge and juror.
We have not bypassed. I have heard all the persons on panel. Please let me complete. We have not bypassed judicial process of our country. It was reported that Robert Blake, Assistant Secretary of State, United States, he had said somewhere that Mr. Modi can apply afresh for visa. We expressed our concern and we have told that the reasons for which a visa was denied to Mr. Modi, the reasons are there today even.
So you have allegiance to the Indian Constitution or allegiance to the American president?
Yes.
Let us be very clear.
What is your view on the judiciary?
Because when you become an MP, Mr. Ratanpudi, we are on a very serious issue here tonight. And I said it, the gravity of the issue is very important because there is a question of privilege which is being raised here. As far as I am aware, and I get Suresh Prabhu in, when you take
Please
an oath as a member of parliament,
I understand my duties and my privileges. Don't try to frighten me.
No, I have no interest in frightening you. All I am telling you today is that
you are a member of parliament
in the Parliament of India. And as a MP in the Parliament of India, you have sworn to bear true faith and allegiance to the Constitution of India as by law established, and to uphold the sovereignty and integrity of India as faithfully discharge the duty upon which
and
you are about to enter.
Why do I violate my oath? Because
if you want to make such a plea,
and allegations without calling them allegations,
because the stated position of the Prime Minister of your country, India, is that this is a matter of concern, a point of principle that Modi has been denied a visa. You are using an MP letterhead. You are not writing in your personal capacity. I'm sorry. You're writing in your personal cup. You are writing as an MP.
No, you're writing as an MP. Yes, I am writing as an MP.
Yes, so you are using your position as a member of India's parliament to lobby.
What is wrong in it? Bypassing your own government. Listen to me. There are many things which Prime Minister of India writes.
Contradicting your government's own position.
Makes fun of that.
Contradicting your government's
position. Mr. Modi makes a fun of what the Prime Minister says day in and day out.
Well, I go back.
Doesn't Mr. Modi violate the constitution then?
Well, let's go to both issues. Suresh Prabhu, you've been a former minister and a leader of the opposition. There are two issues here, Mr. Prabhu. One is the question of the alleged forgery, right? And the second question is whether this letter should have been written at all. Do you think the question of the forgery can be completely discounted? Alleged forgery, and I'm saying underlining alleged forgery, alleged cut and paste job, do you think that can be ignored?
See, this is a very, very serious matter. Number one, we are all members of parliament in India who write a letter against an elected chief minister of India. We have been elected to the parliament through the same process whereby he is elected to as a chief minister. And he has been there for three consecutive terms as the chief minister of a state elected. No party has ever challenged his election. So he has been properly elected under the eyes of and care of the Constitution of India and also under the supervision of the Election Commission. And then a member of parliament supposed to protect rights of all the citizens of India. He is not only a citizen, but he is also chief minister. You write a letter to whom? To a president of a foreign country.
He is not supposed to protect the rights of
his voters. You say deny visa. Getting visa is an inherent right of every citizen. And now you are saying that you are, what are you to saying? What precedent you are setting? So you are telling another country deny visa to our own citizens. We are fighting that our citizens cannot go to US for work, for IT, which says there's $70 billion back home. And therefore, our Prime Minister, everybody goes and takes a position in the United States that denial of visa amounts to discrimination.
And what are we telling US to do? Discriminate. Against whom? Against an elected official in India. That's number one. Number two, some of the people who are written in this letter, whose names feature there, they have always been saying that the US is the biggest butcher. They have used some of these people or their representatives or the parties have used such language, saying that they have butchered, United States have butchered people all over the world, and United States has actually violated all the human rights. So these same people are writing to them. Are they saying that they have given a clean sheet to United States on this matter? Are they saying this? Number three, this letter is not supposed to have been written by many people, as the members of parliament have claimed. If it is so that the MPs are claiming that they never wrote the letter and still the names feature there, it's a very serious matter, obviously. Because if somebody misrepresents them, it's a very serious matter. But what I'm saying is, this only shows one thing, that people are willing to go to any extent to bring down Narendra Modi as a person, and somehow they feel that now within the country they have lost all their possible strengths, so therefore they are now trying to use the United States as a strength. So I will not be surprised. Obama should come and campaign against Narendra Modi in India?
Mr. Suresh Prabhu, it is a nine-month-old letter.
In fact, one more thing.
Whatever the time, how does it matter? You refaxed the letter.
I want to tell you something. What happened in Russia? The United States Congress passed a law against the Russians, saying that if there is any human rights violation in Russia, they will deny visa rights and they will actually forfeit the property. What was the Russian response? Russia passed a similar law and actually did not allow a US congressman to travel to Russia. So we look at another country like Russia.
Very serious questions again being raised on the news this evening. I think the question of self-respect is a very important issue. But the other question is, because I know Sanjay Jha's argument tonight, as I welcoming into the panel, I have an intuitive sense of what Sanjay Jha is about to say. Sanjay Jha is about to say...
We are in telepathy, Yanov.
Yes, we begin to read each other's minds.
Yes.
Sanjay Jha is about to say, if I ask him...
I know exactly what you're going to say right now.
Thank you. Yeah. He's about to say that it's their personal problem. 29 of the 65 MPs on that list are from the Congress party. Is it their personal problem?
The
kind of Shakil Ahmed argument
which
was put up.
It's a convenient thing. Whenever it's inconvenient, say it's a personal view. Mr. Dikvijay Singh's view is personal. Janardhan Dwivedi's view is personal. There is no party view in this party, I think.
What is the party view on this?
Mr. Piyush, it is not like that. Indian National Congress won't subscribe to this type of idea.
What is the Congress party's view in the matter?
Like that.
So does the Congress party subscribe to this letter
that
Narendra Modi should not be given a visa? Shall we take that as your official party view?
I heard Ravi Shankar Prasad acknowledge on your clip some time ago that this is a domestic problem. So I'm very happy to hear from the Bharatiya Janata Party that the human rights violations of Mr. Narendra Modi is a serious domestic problem. I think that's a big confession to make, and I'm glad the BJP is at last becoming honest.
I think, Sanjay, you're going completely off track.
I heard Mr. Chandan Mitra of the Bharatiya Janata Party say in another channel that, you know what, BJP MPs very often sign without reading a document. Well, let me tell you something. If that is the case, then there is enough reason why BJP MPs should
not be... I heard myself say what you were about to say some time back. Will you say whether I said the right thing about what you were about to say? Because I said to you, Sanjay Jha, that you would have said this was the personal point of view of the Congress MPs. I'm asking you, 29 MPs from your party have gone begging to Mr. Obama. 29 MPs of the Congress party have gone begging to Obama, contradicting your Prime Minister. 29
Let me tell you, as Yeah, Arnab, let me answer. And as a responsible spokesperson for the Congress party, the party line on this issue, whether it needs to be given tomorrow or day after, will be given. But let me make one point here. If there are 9 forgeries, there are
you have no party view tonight?
Clearly forged.
You have no party view on it? You are deliberating?
I have to deliberate
so that's
a national
basic
issue?
No. No, 1 minute. We also have our own personal right to make an opinion. Let me make another opinion for you here. That it is an absolute freedom of expression and a right for anyone to make a representation to whoever they want.
Sure.
Right now, the one who's begging is Rajnath Singh, apparently going to America to lobby for Mr. Modi's visa. So the fundamental point is the begging with a bowl is being done by the BJP president, number one. Number two, and a more serious issue that we should be discussing is, why has the United States not given the visa to Mr. Narendra Modi?
Sanjay Jha, you don't have an answer tonight to my question that you dodged it three times? What do you mean? What do you mean? I'm asking you today. I put that question out. I'm asking you today. Suresh Prabhu and Piyush Goyal, I want you to come in on this. I'm on another question here tonight. I'm going to go back to the alleged forgery in some time. But the question tonight is this argument that everything is the personal view. Suresh Prabhu, what do you think? If the personal view of an individual position of a party a person contradicts not just that of the party, but that of the sovereign nation's prime minister, 29 MPs therefore openly contradict their prime minister and go against their government, the position which is upheld by their own parliament in a letter to the US president. Do you buy Sanjay Jha's argument, Suresh Prabhu? Do you buy it?
You know, actually, this is one thing I'm really very surprised that even somebody can still claim that what US action we are trying to justify sitting in India. What is more important is getting visa should be the right of anybody to go. What is the US visa? In fact, if somebody says like this, I think the reaction of Indians should have been that no Indian elected official will ever apply for a visa. On what basis US can deny visa to a particular person discriminating like
about
this?
Edward
that
Snowden
should have been the reaction of somebody
aware.
Like this.
Nobody
rather than
has
that,
a right to a visa.
The action of the United States.
Excuse me, nobody has a right to a visa. No, 1 minute,
no,
Mr.
No,
Prabhu.
I understand.
Nobody internationally has a right to a visa. You have to apply. You can get rejected.
No. I'm not talking about
you're
right.
Very viable. I don't know what
this.
You're saying here.
This is a discriminatory.
And number two, your
it
statement. Mr. Prabhu,
I have a right
your
to apply for a visa.
That just because he's got elected three times, are
have,
you trying to make
about,
a contempt
right
of court
to
the Supreme
visa,
Court?
Right?
The Supreme Court verdict says that even if you're elected and you're tomorrow, you are found to be a criminal, you have to leave. So please let us not get into the trip that just because he's elected, he's got, by the way, he's a prime number one accused in the protest petition of Zakia Jafri. How can you ignore that? Even that is a case and a trial which is on.
I think,
so
Arnab,
don't think that just because you get elected,
I think Arnab, very clearly, there is no court
away.
Proceeding in any law of the in the country, in any court in the country, there is absolutely no court proceeding against Mr. Modi. The law of the land is that he is as yet not even charge sheeted. Forget anything else.
I'm sorry.
They have made all false allegations
in
their letter. National order is the country stands united behind the citizens of India. Whenever we are out of the country, all of us parliamentarians defend the sovereignty and the unity of the country.
My second question is,
we do not take our domestic fights against each other at the Congress or BJP overseas.
I have another serious question to ask. Because there is one report which is going around that the origins of this letter are in the United States of America, which is again worrying me. Because Mr. Syed Aziz Pasha, who is on NewsHour tonight, has said that the initiative of this letter came from an NRI in the United States of America. I want you to tell me, Mr. Pasha, who is the NRI in the United States of America who is so powerful that 65 MPs, or maybe 54 or 55 if 10 are forged, write a letter to Obama? Where did this originate? I want you to reveal that tonight. Mr. Pasha, I'm asking you an important question, please.
Yes, I'm telling.
Yes.
Yes, I'm replying. These persons, they have formed even association, NRA association in USA.
What?
They are.
What is the association's
Hyderabad.
Name?
I know them. They telephone.
What is the association's name?
NRA Association of NRI Muslims Association.
NRI US. Muslims Association.
In US.
NRI Muslims Association so, in the US.
Several persons. Yes, there are several persons from India and Hyderabad also. I know most of them. So they told me that they have already.
No, what is this NRI Muslims Association of the 44. US? Why was the NRI Muslims Association of the US doing this? I mean, who is the person where the initiative came from? I think Piyush is just finding out a little bit more. I can see him tab there on his computer about this. But Shantaram Naik, did you know that this was being originated allegedly from the NRI Muslims Association of
and
the
our
US?
Our MPs are run dictated by ethnic and religious groups.
Did you know, Mr. Naik?
Since some of my colleagues requested me, I have signed it. I did not know the origin. And I found there is substance in the contents, therefore I signed it.
No, but did you know where it came from? Did you check out which interest group it came from?
I did not know who typed it, who wrote it, etc. I don't know. And I agreed with the substance and it was circulated by some of my colleagues. Therefore we signed it.
No, so...
And I agree that visa is a domain of that country.
No, but now that you know, are you worried or surprised that the initiative was not from India, but that somebody sitting in the US was getting the petition
organized?
Does that shock you?
I told you what I know.
But you're surprised.
Well, I told you what I know.
You never knew this before.
I don't know the origin.
You never knew this before.
But I say that no, I never. I only say that substance I agreed, and
that
was
supported
by some of my colleagues.
Well, it is absolute. No, one second. It is absolutely relevant, Mr. Sanjay Jha.
How is that relevant, Arnab? The content that
it is as relevant as the alleged forgery.
Is the whole submission?
It is as relevant as the forgery.
Can go to America to lobby for a visa. It surely individuals have a right to make a representation.
Well, it is.
They have a right to do so. Nothing prohibits them.
Now you have.
They have a right to make a request.
No, there are two new factors, Sanjay.
They're cutting across party lines.
There are two angles. No, there are two angles you cannot undermine. One is that 9 MPs say we didn't sign. It's a Photoshop job. It's a cut and paste job. The second is that the NRI Muslims Association or some such group...
Let that be investigated.
The MPs' conduct has to be investigated. Are these 65 MPs, are they really honest and sincere in their duties to India or to some association of some religious groups? Where is the secularism involved? Where is the secularism that the Congress professes all the time? If they are going to be dictated by religious and ethnic groups overseas in their activities, and a group which says in its aims and objectives that they are going to take donations from state and central government. So a group set up in America, which has as an aim and objective to shall accept grants, contributions, donations, subscription and land for the propagation of the aims and objectives from state and central government, foreign government, institutions, organizations, associations, and other foreign sources. So I don't know if Al-Qaeda is funding them or Lashkar-e-Toyba is funding them.
All over the North
Muslim
America,
Association of India. These are the aims and objectives.
Piyush Goyal, the whole world knows
this is the same.
There are all religious groups funding you in the United States,
no.
In North America.
No, where is he going? Where is he going to? Where are the religious groups funding us? Don't dream up any Hindu groups. We are a secular party. We don't go to divide Indian society. We believe all Indians are one. We don't divide society on religion like you. And we don't get influenced by foreign organizations with ulterior motives and sign letters and forge letters and write to foreign bodies against Indian citizens. This is a breach of privilege of the MPs. This is a breach of faith amongst colleague MPs that some MPs have forged signatures of 9 MPs or a cut and paste job. I think the Speaker and Chairman of the Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha should immediately institute an inquiry, get the CBI into it. Yeah. And all those MPs responsible should be disbarred forthwith.
All those responsible for this?
And the parties who have favoured such letters should answer whether their faith in the judicial system stands.
I put that
whether they are willing to wait and see whether any
but
of these persons, any of these allegations are true.
Wait, Mr. Ratanpuri, do you believe, since you've signed on this, you accept you've signed, I don't know whether you knew this. I don't know this. NRI, Muslim Association of the United States, was trying to back this letter or as Mr. Pasha. Did you know about that?
No, I don't know.
Mr. Pasha, you knew about that.
I don't know.
No, no, one second. Mr. Pasha, you knew about that. Mr. Pasha, you knew about that.
Most of them are there from Hyderabad. I know them personally. So whenever they come
so
to
they contacted
India,
you?
Hyderabad, they meet us.
No, so they contacted you?
Pardon?
They called you?
Who? Yes, they contacted me.
They called
through
you?
Through your friend.
They contacted
Mr. Arnab Goswami.
One second. Don't interrupt
Arnab,
me. One second.
Yeah.
One second, please. So they contacted you, or what did they tell you?
They contacted me through a friend. They could have also contacted me directly, but that day they contacted me through a friend by saying that they already collected 44 signatures from Senate members and House of Representatives in US.
Okay.
So why didn't you also collect some signatures from India?
Oh my God, sir, this is a joint
India.
Letter.
Because the prerogative of giving visa lies with the US government.
What's going on here?
Mr. Sanjay, MPs owning allegiance to the US Congress now?
What's going on here?
MPs are telling them what letter to write and what not to write? This is even more intriguing.
What's going on here, Mr. Sanjay Jha, in your view? That a Muslim Association of the United States is telling...
Congressman from the US.
You don't know? You're not surprised at what's going on? They're trying to put some... We've got 44 Senate members. Now you go collect some Indian MPs. What is going on?
Now, based on what I'm hearing,
yes.
One minute, there is an organization called APCO and many others who do lobbying for Mr. Modi and the BJP. Maybe this is an organization, I have no idea. Maybe lobbying against Mr. Modi.
We have already stated on record,
there is no organization lobbying for Mr. Modi. Goyal,
he's raising irrelevant issues, trying to divert the subject as usual. He never has an answer to the point. He never has an answer to your debate. I suggest you start insisting that your panelists stick to the debate. Where is APCO? Mr. Modi has no agency in the US. This is complete nonsense that Mr. Jha is saying.
No, did it? No, I have,
and alleging all sorts of nonsense
and not answering a charge about these nine forgeries. I find this extremely interesting, what Mr. Pasha is revealing tonight on the news.
No, one second.
So you outsourced the job. This group in the US outsourced the job to you to go and get signatures from Indian MPs. Then what did you do? You went around getting the signatures.
No, it is not. You see, they just told me that they already collected some 44 signatures. So they said because this massacre and genocide took place in India, so in the wake of US administration once again thinking of reviewing the decision, why don't you also request some MPs to sign and send it to...
So Achyutan also signed... There's an MP from your party who you say signed the letter, Mr. Achyutan? Mr. Achyutan signed the letter?
I don't know. He says he don't remember because it is a matter which occurred some 8 months earlier. I don't know whether he remembers or not.
No, he says he hasn't signed the letter. You are contradicting a member of your own party. Who are we to believe? What's going on here? All kinds of things being revealed on the news are tonight that the initiative was in America.
It was some group in America
that outsourced the signing of letters to somebody in India. Nine MPs say we did not sign. Members of parliament are contradicting. There are demands for a criminal investigation. Do you think there should be a criminal investigation, Mr. Ratan Puri, into what was going on here?
Why shouldn't? If somebody has leveled an allegation that his signatures have been forged, that there be forensic examination of those signatures. But I am worried for Mr. Adib. He may not be having the original letter. Now he may have to request again the US government to bail him out to get that original letter.
No, it's not a laughing matter, is it?
You're making, I believe...
It's not a laughing matter, is it, Mr. Ratan Puri? Do you believe somewhere...
You are telling me that if I disagree with the Prime Minister of India, I am committing blasphemy. But this blasphemy is being committed by Mr. Modi day in and day out. Today, he has
try to vilify the most revered Prime Minister of independent India, Jawaharlal Nehru. We know him as the builder of independent India. We know him that he has built the most.
Well, that is, we are not discussing
India,
politics here.
But he is vilifying him.
We are discussing national interest.
Yes,
we are discussing national policy. Do we take our domestic political fights to foreign shows? Do we discuss our internal affairs and internal politics in the US Senate or in US Congress?
This is 9 months old. This is 9 months old.
Whether it's 9 months old or of yesterday, it is immaterial.
To help Mr. Modi.
Gentlemen, whether it's 9 months old or 9 years old, Indian politics is not discussed overseas. It's discussed in India.
No, your politics is not acceptable to us. No, you cannot browbeat us and you cannot frighten us.
For your information,
Suresh Prabhu.
For your information,
Suresh Prabhu.
For your information, Arnab, give me a moment. We were all in the UK and Oxford. We were a parliamentary delegation studying in Oxford, 8 or 9 MPs from all parties. In a student interaction with the students of Oxford,
yes.
One of the students asked about Narendra Modi being denied a visa in the UK.
Yeah.
Before I could answer, one of the signatories in this letter who was with us, he himself answered and he said, no foreign country can deny a visa to an Indian national.
I request
and
you.
And he insisted
you must,
that UK cannot deny that
Mr.
visa.
Mr. Piyush Goyal, you're making a charge without naming the person. I said, name the person.
I can
the
name the person, but I'm hoping that person Piyush will come on record.
You name the person.
And say that he said this in UK.
That's a big allegation. One
it's
second.
It's not an allegation.
I
compliment
you.
That person because when we are abroad,
no,
never bring in politics.
One second.
Leader, Mr. L.K. Advani in the UN, praised Manrega.
One second.
The implementation of which I and all my leaders
I'm saying
when we are abroad, we praise India, we praise Indian
policy. Nobody has a right to a visa of any country.
No, one second. Piyush Goyal says he knows the name of one person.
Gets approved.
Piyush Goyal says.
It's a statement by Piyush Goyal.
One second. Piyush Goyal says.
Ridiculous statement by Piyush
Goyal. Piyush Goyal says.
There's nothing ridiculous in it, Sanjay.
Calm down, gentlemen. Piyush Goyal says there is a member of parliament who has said things against what is in the letter when he is at a seminar in Oxford. And in this letter, he takes another position. I assure you, I assure you, if you name the person, I will get that person on the phone line right now.
I hope he comes himself.
Right now.
The question is...
Name the person.
The question
is,
complimented the person after the interaction.
Name him.
Because when we are out of India,
name him.
We all support India. We don't get into politics.
You are calling that person a hypocrite. Name the person.
No, I don't want to engage in that. That's for the person to realize and apologize for signing this letter.
Politics.
Name
and
the person.
Saying that he should be denied a visa.
Name the person.
Well, I hope you can ask that person or you can ask the members.
I will, but you name the person.
I'm being fair to a colleague in the delegation who had actually stood up for the right cause, stood up for India and did not bring politics.
Name the person.
I suggest you ask the person to come on himself.
Let
the person take a conscience call.
Tell me who to ask.
And decide.
My phone number, there are 3 people outside who will call the person right now and get him on the... Name the person.
Well, I'm being fair. Like you have journalistic privileges, I'm giving my colleague MP the privilege of being a member of parliament.
Come on.
I think in all fairness, he should apologize
Lok Sabha,
for signing
Rajya Sabha.
This letter.
Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha.
He should apologize
Lok Sabha,
for
Rajya
signing
Sabha.
This letter because he had stood up for the right cause 1 year ago. I'm surprised how he signed such a letter. Unless his signature is also a forgery.
Name the person.
Well, I leave it for that person's conscience because he had stood up for the right cause in Oxford
person.
And I had complimented him.
Was Asaduddin Owaisi with you when you went to Oxford? Are you talking of
Asaduddin
Owaisi?
I'm not getting into a debate on the person. I'm going at the cause. The cause is that when we are outside India or when we are dealing with foreign policy, India stands united.
Well,
and the BJP always supports the government in power, whichever it may be, when there is a national issue in the interest of India.
Was it Mausam Noor, Ritesh, Ramasubramanian?
The interest of India is primary.
Suresh
Every
Prabhu,
member of parliament signs...
Suresh Prabhu, criminal investigation, will that help solve this in your view? Should there be a criminal investigation and who should be it be against on this alleged forgery?
No, if it is the member themselves are saying that they never signed a letter and as just one of the person was saying because I am not able to hear properly because I am in Mumbai, far away from that place.
But somebody was saying that the letter was already prepared by the United States. So there is a foreign hand.
Yeah, foreign hand.
Congress party always talks about there is a foreign hand in everything. So I think the foreign hand that they keep talking about is very visible now. But the point is that this foreign hand signed a letter. So the hand wrote the letter. And it said that 25 signatures already collected. So which is that what Sitaram Yechury said is right. It's a cut and paste because 25 signatures were collected by somebody else. Some other member signed something else. And what people claim now they have signed is not the, really the content of the letter. So I think really it calls for a serious review of the entire process. And one more thing which is really important is all the members of parliament as a body should actually be trying to protect the rights of all the citizens of India. Here we are going to another country Mr. telling Mr. them violate the right of a citizen of India,
Mr. Pasha,
which is the right to have.
Mr. Pasha, you don't regret taking instructions from somebody in the United States to do something like this?
I need not take instruction from anybody. If something is really good advice, because I am convinced, that's why I could, not because somebody has directed me, because I am convinced that whatever has happened in Gujarat is really regrettable. So, because the prerogative of giving visa lies with them, even though we don't
even when the worst massacre of independent India in 1984, 5,000 Indians, 5,006 were killed in broad daylight in Delhi by the then government led by the Congress and by the father of the current scion and husband of the chairperson of the UPA. We never took that to foreign shores. We fought the political issues within India. Even we didn't demand that the visa should not be given to them who had orchestrated that crime and many of whom are convicted in court.
Please don't ignore the reality.
Well, Sanjay Jha, Shantaram Nayak, Anand Bhaskar, Rabbalu, Saeed Pasha.
There was a domestic event, Mr. Prabhu. I wish you were embarrassed and humiliated about the way we treated our own fellow citizens.
I wish you were embarrassed and humiliated about the 5,006.
In 2002, courtesy Mr. Narendra Modi.
I hope you were embarrassed. Saying that. I hope you were embarrassed and humiliated about the 5,006 who were murdered, chopped in broad daylight in Delhi in 1984. Under the watch of your Prime Minister, when for 7 days Mr. I.K. Gujral, Mr. Chandrasekhar kept pleading with you and your leaders, bring the army in. And for 7 days you didn't bring the army and let people be massacred. I hope you were humiliated when 58 people were burnt alive in Godhra. Where were you at that time?
Anand Bhaskar Rappalu, before I wrap up, if somebody had forged my letter, if somebody, Anand Bhaskar Rappalu, Mr. Rappalu, if somebody had forged my signature, I assure you, I would have gone to the bottom of it. I would have taken them to court. And I would have instituted criminal proceedings. Are you scared that your party will punish you if you ask for a criminal investigation into who forged your signature? Are you scared?
It is surprising and shocking, Mr. Arnab. Indian National Congress believes in fair deal to each and every individual. And myself, I am not at all interested in this type of forgery activity. And it is very shocking that it is also having the overseas connection in this letter and its
You should immediately go to the police
presentation. And this is not the way. Normally, Indian National Congress will not look towards like that. And we have umpteen number of issues to deal with and
sir,
to
but I'm telling you,
before the
no,
Indian
no,
no,
sir,
population.
But,
to the police station.
But tonight our episode of NewsHour has proved, our episode of NewsHour has proved that there is a foreign hand behind this letter in the first place. That's it.
It's
and you're
shocking.
Being will you go to the police station and get a FIR. Criminal investigation now filed into this? Will you file an FIR?
Let me first look at the papers that they have circulated. Okay. They tried
I
to
think
send
the
to
chairman of Rajya Sabha and the speaker of Lok Sabha should institute the inquiry and file the complaint.
I'm going to send Mr. Anand Bhaskar Rappalu a copy of his forged signature. And then we'll ask him tomorrow whether he's going to file the FIR. Thank you, gentlemen, for joining me on debate number one.